face. All right, I'm going to talk a little bit here about the famous V simile here. This is line 430 to 438 of the Aeneid, Book 1. Now, Aeneas is just looking down, has just looked down upon the city of Carthage with his friend Achates, and they've seen all the working of the Carthaginians. Now, Virgil is comparing them to bees, and it's one of the most famous parts of the Aeneid and something that all Latin students should know. So here we go. So let's take a look at this, and I'll just kind of quickly go through some of the tricky things here. So we start off with qualis. Now, qualis, the problem with qualis is it means like such as, and it's nominative, okay? And it's going with labor. So such labor. And then we have exercet is our verb, and let's kind of figure out what else we got. Exercet. We have, apes. Apes can be nominative or accusative, but since we already have qualis as the nominative, apes should be accusative. Aestate, nova, nice little ablative. Perfloria, rura, very nice. Going with per, little prep phrase, accusative. Floria, of course, an adjective form of the word flower in Latin. Subsole, under the sun. And then we have some nice cum clauses. Okay. So let's start with here first. So such labor, or like we say, like just like the labor of the previous things that we've seen. So we say such labor excites or exercises or busies bees in a new aestate, in a new summer, through the flowery countryside under the sun. Now aestate, of course, comes from aestas. And the nice thing, and it's not aitos, everyone, but it's aistos. Aitos is age, aistos is summer. It has the S in it. That's kind of a little trick that I remember to keep summer, aistos. Also, we get a cool word from this in English, estivate, which is to hibernate in the summer. Okay, so such labor excites the bees in the new summer through the flowery countryside under the sun. And then we have the cum clause. When they lead forth, lead out the adult offspring, of the race. Or when, I'll put it up here, or when they steep hunt, okay, steep hunt, when they stuff liquid honey, okay? Stuff liquid honey. They take liquid honey because they're bees and they're working. And they distend it, okay? Distend it. Nectare kelos. Now, this looks like an infinitive, but it's not. It's from nectar. It is an ablative. Dulce is going with it. And they distend or stretch the cells with honey. Or they accipient, they receive, okay, they receive the burden of the coming bees. Now this should be really invenientium, but it's a contracted form, probably to fit the meter is always the joke that everyone says. So we have here, they lead forth their adult offspring, or when they stuff the liquid honey and fill, or we say stretch out the cells, the little cells in the honeycomb, with nectar, or receive the burden of the coming bees. Or augmine facto. Now, augmine facto here kind of reminds me of earlier in Book 1, when they're talking about the winds. It's a nice verbal echo. Virgil often puts these in here. It's a nice little ablative absolute. Or with, now it's not winds here being augmine, but an augmine of bees. So a nice ablative absolute, PPP facto from facio. With the battle line having been made, the bees arcent. Okay? They arcent. Now can we get this the verb form of arcs? They keep away, and then we have here the phukos. Now, phukos are the drones. They keep the drones away from the hives. Try Sepibus. Okay, so they keep the drones away from the hives, and we have a nice Pecus is in apposition to Fucus, the lazy flock. Okay, because drones don't work. All they do is hang out with the queen. Okay? And then we have here, just continuing with the bee metaphor, the opus ferret. It's feverish. The work, we can say, boils. And the fragrant, fragantia. There's also there's different ways they write this. There's frangalia, fragantia. The fragrant honey smells, we say, with time or of time. It's a nice ablative. So we're just going back and seeing how the bees are all working, doing their thing. Some are kicking the drones out. Some people are taking the burdens of the bees flying into the hive. There's the bees filling the cells with nectar. You know, everyone's working just like the city of Carthage is working. And then after this, we go back to Aeneas. And it's quite nice here. There's no little lead into this. It just suddenly, bam, we hit Aeneas. O fortunati, quorum ya moenia servant. Very nice. And really like this. Because we suddenly go from the Carthaginians to the bees to Aeneas. And Aeneas sees all this and he's jealous. Because he wants what Carthage has. He wants his own city to be founded. He wants to be out there creating a civilization. And he says, O fortunati, O fortunate ones, whose walls now servant, now rise up. Aeneas spoke. And he looks down upon the tops of the city. Astiga Urbis. Very nice. Okay, a little confusing, but quite nice.